Okay, 27. F of x is equal to e power mod x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x. They want to know whether it is 1-1 or not, onto or not. Okay. If you take any negative number, you can understand it is zero. Why? Mod x equal to minus x if x is less than zero. So for every negative number, these two are same. So f of x is zero. So f of x is equal to zero for all x less than equal to zero. Next, when x is positive, mod x you can remove and write x e power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x. Okay, for x greater than zero. Now, first of all, it is not 1-1 because for all negative values it is zero. You can simply write f of minus 1 equal to f of minus 2 equal to 0. So f is not 1. I can give two different x values for which y is same, right? Okay. Regarding onto, for negative values it is 0. For positive values, can anybody give me some idea about what is the range? Can anybody tell me whether this value is greater than 1 or less than 1? Less than 1. Why? Yeah, this is something minus something. This is something plus something. So obviously, this is less than this. Okay. Numerator is less than denominator, means it is less than 1. Okay. So this part is less than 1. Okay. But it is positive. Okay. Because this is greater than this, less than 1 and positive. That means in your code of mind, negative values are there. They are not used. More than 1, lot of values are there. They are also not used. And frankly speaking, the range here is closed 0 to open 1. Because 0 is covered here. Here less than 1, all positive values are covered here. So range is close 0 to 1. Whether exact range you understand or not an issue. You can understand f of x equal to 700, 1000, there is no solution. F of x equal to minus 100, minus 1000, there is no solution. Negative values are not covered. In the code domain, not used. And the values more than 1 also not used. That's why it is not 1-1, not onto. Not 1-1. In fact, if you draw the graph of this, it is always 0 for negative x values. And for positive values, it is tending to 1 like this. Always positive. This is a graph. 0 here and reaching 1. Here it may be a very smooth transition, may not be. That's not an important point. Okay, so exact graph is not required. Exact range is not required. If you substitute some negative values, you'll understand it is not 1-1. If you understand these values are less than 1, you can tell it is not on. Is it okay? Okay, next, 30. Some people find these questions difficult because it is not that there is a formula, put in some numbers, answer will come. You have to think a little bit. Okay. Okay, 30. F of x is equal to x by 1 plus mod x. Okay. First of all, this is an odd function. Whenever x is positive, it is positive. Whenever x is negative, it is negative. X greater than 0 implies f of x is greater than 0. X less than 0 implies f of x is less than 0. And f is odd function. Okay. I think it is 1-1. I'll tell you why. Yesterday, where I was teaching another class, it's okay. Let us take another question. F of x equal to 5 plus 3x by 2 plus x. Look at this. I can tell it is 1-1 very easily. Okay. It is not that I'm drawing the graph of this. So that also I can tell. How? If I take equal to 7 and solve, how many solutions will come? If I take f of x equal to 7, find x values, how many solutions will come? Only one. Do cross multiplication, a linear equation, you'll get only one. If I take equal to 10, one solution. If I take equal to 2 by root 3, okay. That means you take any element in the codomain, you will get only one pre-image. If you get two pre-images, it's not one one, two or more. But there is no, whatever k you take, all right, we'll only get unique solution. Okay, that means it is one one. It's a slightly different way of proving it. Okay. Can anybody tell me, for a particular k, there is no solution. What is that k? If you take equal to 2 or equal to 5 or equal to 10, you'll get solution. You're equal to 9 or equal to 1 by 5. But there's one number, if you take, you'll not get any solution. 3, yes. If you take equal to 3, 3x and 3x will cancel. You'll get 5 equal to 6, which is something absurd. Okay, so 3 is there in the codomain, but no element is connecting to that because there's no solution. Okay, so from that itself, we can tell what's the range of this then? All real numbers except 3. Those elements in the codomain which have pre-images to put together is called range. Except 3, every other number have pre-images. So in the codomain, 3 is not used, everything else is used. So I can tell its range is all real numbers except 3. And I can also tell it is 1, 1. Because whichever k I am taking, I am getting unique solution. Same logic here. When x is positive, it is x by 1 plus x. And when x is negative, it is x by 1 minus x. If I take equal to whatever number I want, 7, 900, I'll get a unique solution. There's no chance of getting two solutions. All right? Okay. Almost same thing can do. You can bring this x down and write 1 by x plus 1. If somebody takes f of x1 equal to f of x2, if you prove x1 equal to x2, you proved 1, 1. Okay, it is possible to prove here. Why? You write 1 by x1 plus 1. 1 by x2 plus 1. You can cancel 1. 1 by x1 equal to 1 by x2 means x1 equal to x2. You did not get anything else. You got only x1 equal to x2. So it is 1. All right. Okay. So that is one way to prove. Another way is if you take equal to k, you will get unique solution. Another way to understand this is you can find the derivative and it's an increasing function. As it is, you can find the derivative or you can find something. Let us find derivative of this. 1 plus mod x into what is the derivative of x? 1. Minus x into what is the derivative of mod x? Anybody knows what is the derivative of mod x?
X by mod x.
Mod x by x or x by mod x? Because derivative of mod x is plus 1 when x is positive, minus 1 when x is negative. Put together, it is mod x by x. By 1 plus mod x whole square. X and x will cancel, mod x and mod x will cancel. Derivative is 1 by 1 plus mod x whole square. So it's positive. If derivative positive, it is a strictly increasing function. Okay. You can also see without differentiation that it is increasing. How? Look at this carefully. When I am increasing x, what will happen to 1 by x? Decreases. What will happen to 1 by x plus 1? Decreases. What will happen to reciprocal of that? That's a little increasing function proved. Right? Okay. So it is an increasing function. In fact, if you want me to draw the graph, it is like this. Because at infinity, the limit is 1. When x is tending to infinity, this limit is 1. When x is tending to minus infinity, this limit is minus 1. And when x is positive, it is positive. When x is negative, it is negative. 0 becomes 1. 0 becomes minus 1. A strictly increasing function. Okay, so it is 1, 1. It would have been on 2 if codomain is open interval minus 1 to 1. But they gave codomain as all real numbers. Okay, your range is open interval minus 1 to 1. You can understand also very easily. Whenever x is positive, this is smaller, this is bigger. Because plus 1 is there. Smaller by bigger is always less than 1. In the range, more than 1 will not be there. Whether exact range is this, you understood or not an important thing. You can understand the range cannot cover more than 1, but in the codomain, those values are there. So it is not onto. It is 1, 1, but not onto. Why it is 1, 1? I gave many explanations. One, it is increasing function, another is graph. I started with f of x1 equal to f of x2, and I got x1 equal to x2 only, nothing else. any one of these, you can understand it as 1. Or you take equal to k, every time you are getting a unique solution. So I'm explaining in different ways. Okay, next to 33. Past main questions are good. There are just on bijection, there are 15-20 questions are there. Okay, at least 10-15 questions are there. All are nice. Yeah, starting from 20 all the way up to 35 or something, all are about 1-1 and on 2. Okay. So after doing this many questions, you cannot say still I don't know how to find 1-1 or 2. You'll get some maturity, overall idea. Okay. Coming to this, and f is from 0 to infinity to 0 to infinity. Okay, if you feel that it is not 1-1, you have to try to create an example. Okay, for example, if you put x equal to 3, let us say answer is 2/3, right? I think I can give two different x values where answer is 2/3. How? Take mod 1 minus 1 by x equal to 2/3. Try to solve it. 1 minus 1 by x equal to plus or minus 2/3. You'll get 1 minus 1 by x equal to 2/3 or 1 minus 1 by x equal to 1/3. When I solve, I'll get x equal to 3. Here, when I solve, I'll get x equal to 3/2. Okay. Now, reverse. Say now that f of 3 is equal to f of 3/2 is equal to 2/3. So, f is not 1-1. Two different numbers. Okay. Because at 3, this 1 minus 1/3 is 2/3. And when you put 3/2, it is 2. No, it is 1/3. Something wrong in solving here. This is 1 minus 1/3 is 2/3. No, this is wrong error. Minus 2/3 I should write. Then you look on 5/3, 3/5. Sorry about that. Yeah. When I put 3/5, look on 5/3. 1 minus 5/3 is minus 2/3. And mod of minus 2/3 is plus 2/3. Okay. So I don't know two numbers where answer is same. So what I have done, I took one x value, found the answer. That answer I equated here and tried to solve it back. I took 3, I got 3 back, but I got one more answer. From that, I am able to create an example. Okay. So one example is good enough to tell it is not 1-1. Or we have to draw the graph. Okay. The example is very simple. What I wrote, f of 3 is equal to f of 3/5 is equal to 2/3. Okay, what is the graph of 1 by x? It is like this. Graph of minus 1 by x, it is like this. This is a graph of y equal to 1 by x. This is a graph of y equal to minus 1 by x. If I add 1, I have to move it upward. Okay. So 1 is here, minus 1 by x, right? So this one and this one. Okay. Now comes the main part. They want mod here. When you apply mod, anything below x-axis, you have to take it up. So this is 0. This part will remain as it is, but this piece will go up. It will be like this. And it will be like this. Okay. So between 0 to infinity, the graph is this. You can see a horizontal element has intersect twice. So it is not 1-1. Okay. If you want to give an example, this is one example, you can give more. How to create an example? You take after 1 any number you want, 5, 700, 1000. Find answer for this. That answer you equate it here and try to solve it. You will get two answers. One is what you took and one more. You can easily tell that. Okay, so some questions are not all that easy telling 1-1, non 2, because sometimes you may have to have the graph. Sometimes you have some overall maturity about the function, whether increasing, decreasing, and all the details. Okay, sometimes they may be easy. Okay, from this figure, you can tell the range. This is covering all positive values, right? If you take y coordinates of all the points put together, that is called range. is covering 0 to infinity everything, but including 0. To be frank, what they gave is not even a function. Why? One is there in the domain. What is the image of one when you put x equal to 1? 0. 0 is there in the codomain? Not there, open interval. That means I have one here, but I don't have anything to connect here. One element is left in the domain. Is it a function? No. So I think there may be a typing mistake or some kind of add score. That is the reason add score. Yes. Down it is written there. You can see add score. Why it is add score is because one doesn't have image. If you want to make the question a little more correct, you put 0 closed. Then what will happen? It is not 1, 1, but it is onto. But as it is not a function. Okay, so without all these things, you can simply say f of 1 is not defined. So it is not a function. That's why it is add score. But you should also know if the question is slightly changed and made it correct, how to do it. Okay, next to C36. Okay. Okay, 36, what is this? They want inverse function. Let f and 2a be a function and y, where y is a natural number and y equal to 4x plus b something. If g is inverse of f, then what is g of y? In menu? Reject this in. Okay, 36, let me read what is this. Okay, normally how do you find inverse function? We'll do it. F of x equal to y, 4x plus 3 equal to y. F of x equal to y means x equal to f inverse y. And x is equal to y minus 3 by 4 and that x is f inverse y. F inverse y is called g of y, that's all. G is inverse of f. Nothing much here. G of y is y minus 3 by 4. Why they give that y equal to 4x plus 3 is not so important, I guess. Oh, they just want to make it bijection, so they define like that. Okay. Finding inverse function is very, very easy. You take f of x equal to y, somehow find x in terms of y. Okay. That what you got is f inverse y. Okay, 39. they gave f of x is equal to x plus 1 whole square minus 1 and x greater than equal to minus 1. They want f of x equal to f inverse x. How many solutions are there? Who is talking here? Actually, question should be given more nicely where unless something is a bijection, we cannot talk about inverse. If you want to talk about bijection, they should tell domain and codomain clearly. Okay. I think what they want is f from minus 1 to infinity to minus 1 to infinity. Actually, the graph of this, x square is u-shape, x plus 1 whole square move towards left. By one unit and then bring down by one unit. 0 and minus 2. And this point is minus 1 comma minus 1. This total graph is not a bijection because if you draw a horizontal line, it will intersect twice. Okay. So it's not 1-1. But if you take only this piece or only this piece, it is 1-1 and on 2 depending on the suitable codomain. So if you take domain minus 1 to infinity, codomain minus 1 to infinity is exactly this piece. All right. Okay. Now they asked how many solutions are there. One important thing about inverse function, when you take y equal to x line, if this is a graph of y equal to f of x, it's a mirror image with respect to this will be y equal to f inverse x. F of x and f inverse x are graphs are mirror image of each other with respect to y equal to x line. Why? For the simple reason, according to coordinate geometry, image of a comma b with respect to line y equal to x is b comma a, right? So if originally 2 comma 5 satisfies in original function, in image function 5 comma 2 should satisfy, because if 2 is connected to 5 here, 5 should be connected to 2. That's a simple reason. Okay, why I'm talking about this anyway? At 0, what is the derivative of this? 2 into x plus 1, 2. Okay, so this has slope 2, so y equal to x will actually pass through the like this. Okay, this is actually graph of y equal to x passing through exactly minus 1 comma 1 and 0 comma 0. When you find mirror image of this piece with respect to this, it will come like this, isn't it? Okay, you can see how many times they're intersecting. 2 times, one time at minus 1, one time at 0. 2 solutions, very simple from the figure. I'll just draw one simple figure. Our original graph is only this piece and its mirror image only this piece. How many times they're intersecting? Twice. And what are they? Minus 1 and 0. Okay, so 2 solutions. F of x is equal to f inverse x has 2 solutions, which are actually minus 1 and 0. That is one way to do it. Another way is, instead of solving f of x equal to f inverse x, you apply f on both sides, you get f of x is equal to x. What is f of x? F of inside f of x is x plus 1 whole square minus 1. That you substitute back in this, you will get x plus 1 whole square minus 1 plus 1 whole square minus 1 is equal to x. Now, minus 1 and 1 will cancel. I will get x plus 1 whole power 4. One those sides will get x plus 1. When I solve this, we will get x plus 1 equal to 0. After cancelling x plus 1, we will get x plus 1 whole cube equal to 1. That will give you x plus 1 equal to 1. Again, you got it. X equal to minus 1 or 0. Same solution. 2 solutions. Another method is you can find inverse function. Okay, one method is from the graph, one method is f of x will take solve it, you got 2 solutions. Another method is let us find f inverse x. Take f of x equal to y, x plus 1 whole square minus 1 equal to y, x plus 1 whole square is equal to y plus 1, x plus 1 equal to square root of y plus 1, and x is equal to minus 1 plus root over y plus 1. Now, when you take f of x equal to f inverse x, really f of x equal to f inverse x. What is f of x? X plus 1 whole square minus 1. F inverse x minus 1 plus root x plus 1. Again, we have to try to solve this equation. Minus 1 will cancel. Square it. You will get x plus 1 whole power 4 equal to x plus 1. Same equation. and you got it. So we really found inverse function and equated f of x equal to f inverse x. We got some solution, or this way, anyway is okay. All right. Okay, erased already. I can manage. Okay, 42. X equal to 2 line is there. There is a graph symmetrical about it. Okay. Maybe it is like this here. Okay, that means with respect to this, you can fold it kind of thing. Okay, the graph is symmetrical about this line. Then what can you infer? Basically, when it is symmetrical, what does it mean? From here, you go k units forward, you find the value, or k units backward, you find the value. They should be same, right? That's what symmetrical means. From here, you travel k units this side or k units this side and find y coordinate. It should be same every time. So that is exactly 2 plus k here, 2 minus k. So f of 2 minus k should be f of 2 plus k for all k belongs to R. Then I can say it is symmetrical about x equal to 2 line. In the place of k, x is there. That is option. That's it forward. Option D, f of 2 minus x equal to f of 2 plus x. But you can also express this another way. Let it take 2 minus k equal to some x. Then k will be what? 2 minus x. So this I can write f of x. This, when I put 2 minus x back, 2 plus k will become 4 minus x, which is f of 4 minus x. So when something is symmetrical about x equal to 2 line, you can also say f of x is f of 4 minus x. Here our question is over. F of 2 minus x equal to f of 2 plus x sufficient. But I'm just saying they can ask another question in the exam where they can talk about this. And we use this in integration. How do we use it in integration? Let us say something is symmetrical about A. This is 0, this is 2A. This area is same as this area. So integral 0 to 2A f of x dx is same as 2 times integral 0 to A f of x dx. When is that? When f of 2a minus x is equal to f of x. Whenever f of 2a minus x equal to f of x means the graph is symmetrical about x equal to a line. All right. Even we use this also, we use it in somewhere in integration. Okay, I think now I'll just discuss from 43 onward backward whatever is possible by the time. Okay. Okay, why don't you try 43, 41, just 2 minutes, I'll come back. Okay, I forgot that 42 questions are also we have to do today. So only 5 questions are there. We'll complete them and then we'll come back. Okay. Please don't waste time. And today try to complete all the rest of the questions, whatever is left, because tomorrow I have to start limits, tell some theory also. I have to clarify your doubts also. I did not bring part 2 book, if you don't mind, can you? Okay, so those who have taken offline people, especially print of this, part 2 is there at the last 90 pages. Okay, I hope all of you know that 2020 questions we gave separately as a part 2, which is at the end of this book. Okay, in that page number 1, within that second part, okay, without 90 pages, why to print a separate book and separate spiral binding, we just kept in this. Okay, so there are only 5 questions which are given in 2020. Let us see. Please don't talk. Please don't talk. Okay, so very first question, they gave g of x is equal to x square plus x minus 1. G of f of x is equal to 4x square minus 10x plus 5. Quite. They want f of 5 by 4. Okay. Okay, let me see from this what is g of f of x. It is f of x whole square plus f of x minus 1. This and this should be equal. Okay, I think from that I can find f of x, but I'll get 2 answers. I guess both are right. They did not mention which one it is. Okay, so you take f of x whole square plus f of x minus 1 is equal to 4x square minus 10x plus 5. I can put 5 by 4 right in the beginning, get a quadratic equation, then find it. Okay. But x equal to 5 by 4, this is f of 5 by 4 whole square. This is f of 5 by 4 minus 1. When I put 5 by 4, this is 25 by 4. When I put 5 by 4, it is 25 itself or 25 by 2. Yeah, plus 5. Okay, I'll take f of 5 by 4 as t, t square plus t minus 1. And what is this number? Minus 20 by 4. 5 minus 25 by 4, 20 minus 5 by 4. Okay. Okay, this is a quadratic equation. I can solve it. Otherwise, 4 t square plus 4 t minus 4 minus 5 means plus 1 equal to 0. Oh, it so happened it became perfect square. I did not expect that I'll get only one answer. I thought I'll get 2 answers, but it became perfect square. 2t plus 1 whole square equal to 0, t equal to minus 1. Okay. Normally, I would have got 2 answers. Okay. If it is not 5 by 4, if it is some other number. Okay. Oh, those who have the book, you found out this page, right? Anybody want to tell what is the minimum value of g of x here? X square plus x minus 1. Minus 5 by 4, is it? I can add 1 by 4, subtract 1 by 4. It is minus 5 by 4. But I want plus 5 by 4. It's okay. There is another way to do this. Anybody want to tell me, forget about all this, just look at this and look at this. F of x will be a linear expression or a quadratic expression or cubic expression? Just by looking at this and looking at this, what is f of x will be? Linear, right? Okay. So, you can find f of x another way. Let us assume f of x as ax plus b and take it as g of ax plus b is equal to 4x square minus 10x plus 5. Because if f of x is quadratic, g of f of x will be fourth degree, quadratic whole square, right? Okay, now if you can find a and b, your job is done. Very easy now. What is g of ax plus b when you expand? Ax plus b whole square plus ax plus b plus 1. That should be 4x square minus 10x plus 5. You can compare the coefficients and tell a value, b value also. What is x square coefficient? 4 and here. So we'll get a square equal to 4, one equation. Compare x coefficients. Ah, this is minus 1. Thank you. Compare x coefficients. Here we'll get 2ab and here we'll get a, and that should be minus 10. Compare constants. You will get b square plus b minus 1 equal to 5. Okay. I'm just arranging this. People have done the first method, right? Okay. Now, when I solve this, b square plus b equal to 6, I'll get b equal to 2 or b equal to minus 3. Okay. Two solutions for there. From this, I'll get a equal to 2 or a equal to minus 2. But I want a into 2b plus 1 should be minus 10. When a is 2, what is b should be from this? Minus 5 minus minus 3. B should be minus 3. When a is minus 2, this should be plus 5, this should be 4, b should be 2. Okay. Are both okay? Then f of x will have two options. Let us see. F of x can be 2x minus 3 or f of x can, sorry, f of x only, yes, minus 2x plus 2 from this. If a is 2, b must be minus 3, and if a is minus 2, b must be plus 2. That is also there. Okay, fine. If I take this, what is f of 5 by 4 answer? 5 by 2 minus 3, minus of. If I take this and find f of 5 by 4, what is the answer? Minus 5 by 2 plus 2 minus of. Oh, I have two options, but in both cases, the answer is coming same. The f of x is not unique. Okay, f of 5 by 4 is unique. But f of x is, two options are there. If anything is okay. And both are giving same answer. That is another way to do that. Is it fine? The first method is good, where we don't have to worry about what is f of x. But if somebody asks you what is f of x, that itself is nice. The second method. basically in a quadratic expression, when you're replacing x with something ax plus b and you're getting another one, what is that you are doing? You are translating it, and when you multiply the number, you can also what's called open it or close it. So you are doing that. Linear transformation. Okay. Second question. They just gave a function and asked inverse. I said how to find inverse. Simply take f of x equal to y. Somehow try to find x in terms of y. So f of x is equal to 8 power 2x minus 8 power minus 2x by 8 power 2x plus 8 power minus 2x. You take equal to y. You can do cross multiplication or you can do component or dividend. I'll take the reciprocal. First of all, 8 power 2x plus 8 power minus 2x by 8 power 2x minus 8 power minus 2x is 1 by y. You apply component or dividend. Numerator plus denominator by numerator minus denominator. Here also numerator plus denominator, numerator minus denominator. When you take numerator plus denominator, you'll get 2 times 8 power 2x. Numerator minus denominator, 2 times 8 power minus 2x. Is 1 plus y by 1 minus y. 2 and 2 will cancel. 8 will go up. You'll get 8 power 4x is equal to 1 plus y by 1 minus y. I'll get log with base 8, but they want, they also want base 8 only after all. 4x is equal to log of 1 plus y by 1 minus y base 8, or you apply log on both sides, that is better. Just apply log with base e. You'll get 4x log 8 base c is equal to log with base c 1 plus y by 1 minus y. Now divide with log 8 and divide with 4. You will get x is equal to 1 by 4, 1 by log 8 base c into log of 1 plus y by 1 minus y. This is f inverse y. If you want f inverse x, you have to write x here. Okay, and log 8 base, if you take to numerator, it will become log e base 8 if required. Yeah, that is option C. 1 by 4 is there, it will become log e base 8, log 1 plus x by 1 minus x, option B. Okay, so how to find inverse function? So this is one example. Find f of, take f of x equal to y, somehow find x in terms of y, and x you replace with f inverse y. F inverse x means wherever y is there, write x, that is f inverse x. Right? Okay, next one. F is a function from R to R. F of x is equal to 1 plus x mod x. F of x is equal to 1 plus x mod x. The defined signal function, we know about signal function. Whenever x is positive, its value is plus 1. Whenever x is negative, its value is minus 1. That is the definition of signal function. At 0 also, they defined as 1. That is up to their choice. Okay. Now they want whether it is invertible or not. When x is positive, it is 1 plus x square. 1 plus x square graph is this. When x is negative, it is 1 minus x square. It is actually like this. This is also strictly increasing function. If somebody wants, you can find derivative and see it. What is the derivative? One derivative is 0. X into derivative of mod x is mod x by x. Mod x into derivative x is 1. Xx will cancel. You are getting 2 mod x. Derivative is 2 mod x. 2 mod x is positive. Or you take plus and minus separately. and it is positive derivative with 2x, which is positive. When x is negative, derivative is minus 2x, which is also positive, because x is negative, minus 2x is positive. It is a strictly increasing function. You can see range is all real numbers. It is both 1 and non 2, so it is invertible. Okay, so one of the option is avoided now. Now if it is invertible, what is that inverse? They are asked. Okay, so how will you find inverse? You have to take f of x equal to y. Let f of x is equal to y. Then I have to take two cases here. 1 plus x square equal to y if x is positive. 1 minus x square equal to y if x is negative. Because f of x has two definitions. When x is positive, it is this. When x is negative, it is this. I can send one this side. When if I try to find x, I'll get plus or minus root y minus 1. But I should take only plus because my x is positive here. In this case, I should take x as root y minus 1 only, not a minus here, because my x is positive. Here, when I send this one here, I may get x square equal to 1 minus y. I may get plus or minus root 1 minus y, but I should take minus only because x is negative. So this will give me x equal to minus of root over 1 minus y. Here also, actually, you'll get plus or minus, but you should change plus only. Here also, I'll get plus or minus, but I should choose minus only because my x is negative. Okay. So basically, your f inverse y is equal to square root of y minus 1 when y is greater than 1. Why? Here, what is the range of 1 plus x square? More than 1, no? That we are talking about this piece. All right. And this is less than 1. So this is equal to minus root over 1 minus y when y is less than 1. We cannot see this part in the online. This is one part, and minus of root 1 minus y if y is less than 1. Now we have to see what is the best way to represent these two together. This is not an easy question. One has to do very carefully, because this piece inverse will have one formula, this piece inverse will have another formula, and those y values are greater than 1 and less than 1. Okay, one requires a good knowledge. Now, how to express in a signum form is that both this and this, the inner part is positive. So I'll tell you how to combine both. I'll write here. This and this put together, you can write square root of mod y minus 1. Or you can write mod 1 minus y. Both are same. Why? When y is more than 1, y minus in positive, I can remove mod as it is will come. And y is less than 1, it will be negative. When I remove mod, minus of this will come, which is 1 minus y. That is fine. But how will you manage outside plus or minus? One time plus should come, one side minus will come. That is signum of y minus 1. Because when y minus 1 is positive, plus 1 will come. When y minus 1 is negative, minus should come. Okay. So this is your f inverse y, including both. Okay. So you should understand, inside I took mod, and outside to get plus or minus, I have to take signum function. Okay, that is option D, signum function of x minus 1 into root over mod x minus 1. Okay, so 4 and 5 I not done in this 2020 papers. Okay, you can do that 4 and 5. And in the other questions, whatever I not done, those questions. Tomorrow, first half an hour, I'll tell some limit theory and we'll do a few questions. Second half an hour, I'll discuss doubts in today's work. Okay, so try to complete today's work today only. All right, thank you.